Hello everyone, welcome to my second YouTube channel. And the first channel was Aspen Tech channel Muhammad Haris Humayun, where I have uploaded the videos related to the Aspen, Aspen Hisis, Aspen Plus, Aspen Exchanger Design and Rating, Aspen Energy Analyzer. And this is my second YouTube channel, which is the Chemical Engineering channel. And this channel is basically dedicated to various aspects of chemical engineering, like chemical process industries, fluid mechanics, heat and mass transfer, chemical reaction engineering, and so on. On this channel, we will be uploading the videos lecture-wise of each category. Like, we are starting today with the chemical process industries, and in chemical process industries, we will be dividing this into various lectures. Then we will move to other part, like fluid mechanics, then to heat transfer, mass transfer, CRE, plant design, and so on. So what is the objective of this course? Number one is to understand the process occurring in major industries during product manufacturing process from raw material to product. Obviously, we know that a process starts with the raw material and ends at some product. So we have to understand the dynamics, the processes which are involved during the process. Obviously, there are various processes, physical process, chemical process. So we will be discussing these in detail to gain knowledge about the basic unit operations and process in industries. Obviously, unit operation deal with the physical processes and unit process deal with the chemical processes, and complete knowledge of process flow diagrams, which is PFD, BFD and industrial symbols. BFD stands for block flow diagram, PFD stands for process flow diagrams. So the books which I recommended for this is Shreve's Chemical Process Industries, Riegel's Handbook of Industrial Chemistry, a textbook of chemical technology, and Encyclopedia of Chemical Technology by Kirk Othmer. So what are the today's course proceedings? Number one is to first understand what are the tasks of a chemical engineer, then the general steps which are included in chemical processes, industrial manufacturing process, chemical process design with its requirements, example of a process. So what are the tasks of a chemical engineer? Obviously, the chemical engineer have to do various tasks. It is called as an all-rounder among all engineers. So its number one task is to convert the innovation to a product, because we have to sell the product. First, we get some innovation and then we have to translate into some product. And obviously, we have to design a process or a plant to make it happen. And obviously, that includes the research and design, the chemical production, construction and operation of industrial plants. Then they design equipment for safe storage and handling and transportation of chemical solids, liquids and gases. Then the control system, because obviously for a successful plant operation, the control system should be perfect or adequate for it to run. So design control system for chemical plants based on data from lab experiment and pilot plant operations. And last but not the least, they also perform tests and take measures in order to determine the most efficient production methods. Obviously, the role of a chemical engineer to select the production technique which is the best possible technique among the various production techniques for the same product, and then have to design the plant, have to erect the plant, commissioning, installation, operation, and obviously have to improve it as well. So if we talk about it, the general manufacturing plants or the general steps that starts with the raw material, the treatment process, the reaction process, the separation, and the final product. Obviously, if we divide the overall system, that reactor or the reaction process is the core of our chemical plant. These are the pre-treatment steps and these are the post-treatment steps. The pre-treatment steps include the raw material, the treatment like filtration and so on, different techniques, then the reaction system, then the post-treatment which includes cyclone, separator and different techniques, distillation and so on, and then we get the final product. If we talk about the industrial manufacturing process, obviously a unit operation, unit process, or a combination of both may be required to convert raw materials into final products. It may include catalyst, additives as well, and the final product also accompanied with byproducts and recycled products as well. But this is not limited to this part only. It also includes the industrial management, which include site location, supply chain management, available of utilities, and human resource management. You have to understand it that all the technical work is obviously going on here, but your task once you are going to the industry is to do the management process. And this management process is the fundamental, or I can say the core process once you are operating a plant, because technically you are strong, that is good. But if you are a bad manager, you don't have a place in that industry for so long. So obviously, industrial management is also a key part. Effluent disposal, climate, environment, local community consideration, and political and strategic considerations. So all these aspects have to be taken into account while going through an industrial manufacturing process. Now, what are the requirements of a chemical process design? The production rate, the capacity, and the product which is required. How much purity is required? Like you require 99% methanol or 99.5% methanol. Obviously, even this 0.5% recovery or the 0.5% change can lead to different number of stages in the distillation column, different reflux ratio, and so on. Raw material to be used, obviously, for different process or for different techniques, different raw materials could be used in the process. The available utilities, what utilities you have? You have steam, water, chillers, chilling water, and so on. What type of utilities you are having in the system? What will be the process route? That is important because it will determine the raw material in the system. Because for different routes, the raw materials could be different in the process. Expected market, to which market you are going to sell the product? Because if there is no market for this product, there is no need to make this product. So I can say it goes like that, or maybe hierarchy wise it will be a different, but obviously it will start with the expected market, and from that expected market need you will determine the production need, the production rate, the purity, and then you will come to the raw material, then you will come to the process route and utility available, and obviously the site selection again plays a vital role in it. However, this does not end there, and there is always a need to find a better solution from several alternatives. Then again, process flowsheet description, mass and energy balances, result, equipment sizing and specification, economic feasibility analysis, environmental requirements. And finally, the final report. Obviously, if you have done your FYDP, the final year design project, or if you are new to the FYDP, you have to understand that you have to first select a process. Or I can say these all aspects are included in your FYDP. Now, what you are doing in FYDP? Obviously, in an FYDP project, you have to first select a title. And that title is obviously based on the market requirements. Then you have to select the production capacity. And obviously, it depends on the need of the country and particular facility. Then you have to select the process, because to make the product, there could be different process alternatives. And you have to select the best of them, obviously, based on different advantages, disadvantages, and so on. Then, once you have done this, you have to prepare the process flow sheet, or I can say process flow diagram of the system. And then you have to do the material balance, energy balance, costing, designing, so on. And all these aspects are covered in. So this is the overall process design you are doing. And again, it includes various plant design aspects like the site selection, the mechanical design of the equipment, and construction of the plant. These all aspects include the plant design, while the previous aspects include the process design. Now, if you look at the refinery process, this process is a detailed process and core of the chemical engineering. There are two types of distillation in the system, atmospheric and vacuum distillation. Obviously, we will talk about it once we get more and more into this course. The crude oil is sent to the atmospheric distillation, and obviously to vacuum distillation, the LPG gas, straight run gasoline, different way products are producing, hydrotreating, catalytic reforming, alkylation, treating and blending, hydrotreating, and different aspects are included in the system. Now, based on this refinery process, we can divide the process into two types, the physical processes and chemical processes. So there are two types of processes, physical and chemical process. Now, physical process include distillation, solvent extraction, propane desulfating, solvent de-waxing, and blending, while the chemical processes are of two nature, thermal and catalytic. And in thermal, it includes visp breaking, delayed coking, flexi coking, while catalytic include hydrotreating, catalytic reforming, catalytic cracking, hydrocracking, catalytic de-waxing, and alkylation. So obviously, we will be learning these systems or these processes once we get more and more into this subject. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe the channel. Please do like the video, share the video, watch the video, and subscribe to the channel, Chemical Engineering channel, and also subscribe to my second channel, which is the Aspen Tech channel. Stay tuned for the next lecture on chemical process industries. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.